Hey, I'm Pete Gluzek, and I'm going to talk to you today about something a lot of people take for granted, and it's casting. And you know, I can't tell you how many people come into my boat for an on-water training session or a guide trip, and they have trouble with their casting. They're missing fish because they're not getting the baits to the targets. And there's a couple things that you need to do. I'm going to show you how to cast. I'm going to give you some instructions on how to become a better caster. And the first piece of equipment I'm going to talk about is a spinning rod. This is a Denali spinning rod. It's 7 foot in length. That's what I recommend. Most people get medium heavy action, 7 foot in length. It's the best all around rod for a guy that's just having one or two spinning rods. That's a great all around rod. And how you cast a spinning rod, and I'll start really from the very beginning, is you're going to grab the line with your index finger. You're going to dangle your bait about 2 feet from the tip of the rod, no more. You're going to flip the bail manually. Now you're ready to make your cast. Now, what I do is I'll point my target, I point my rod at my target. Okay, this is where I start my cast. Of course, I got to make sure that there's nobody in my back cast. You know, you want to make sure that you're not going to hit anybody during your cast. But I like to point my rod at the target. That really helps me with my accuracy. And I make one smooth motion. You'll find that I do this in my bait casting and my spinning casting. And how I simply do it is there's a couple different casts. There's the overhand cast, there's the backhand cast, and then there's the forehand cast. And I'm going to back up a little bit here so I don't hit my cameraman. But I do a roll, and you'll see how I do it. It's almost like a lasso where I'm rolling the bait. Okay, you're rolling and you're keeping constant tension on that during the cast. And it's the same thing with the backhand cast. You want to be equally effective with all three casts, because the backhand cast is going to allow you to get around the back corner of cover when you go past it on your boat, and your forehand cast, of course, is going to allow you to get around that other corner. And the backhand and forehand cast do two great things. They keep the bait low to the water during the cast. What that does is it minimizes your splash when the bait hits the water. Very, very important stuff. Now, your longest cast is going to come overhand. A lot of times I use two hands for this cast, is overhand. Now, if you'll notice during my casting, my elbows stand really tight to my body. Okay, a lot of people are using a lot of arm motion. It's not the best way to cast. The key is getting good rod tip speed, and you accomplish that with your wrist by keeping your elbow tight to your body. Okay, so now I'm gonna make a simple overhand cast. Okay, and we're doing for distance. We threw it way out there. Now you'll notice what I did with my fingers. I stopped the line. I used my left or my right hand to control that line as the bait's hitting the water. That minimizes my splash and it increases my casting accuracy. And if you make a bad cast where it's going to head up into the tree, you can stop it. So use your right and left hand to control that line as it's escaping off the spool. Now, here's a key. A couple keys that are going to be incredible for you when it comes to using spinning equipment. Always flip the bail with your hand. Don't use your reel handle to flip the bail. Flip the bail with your hand. It minimizes line twist. The other thing you do is I pull taut before I start reeling. Okay, that also minimizes line twist. Line twist wind knots is your biggest enemy in spinning equipment. But using these two steps, it's going to really minimize the amount of line twist you have. And then sometimes I'll even go to the level of effort where I grab the line up here. So I'm always reeling in taut line. That's critical. Okay? So that's how I cast. That's how I manage my line. I keep my elbows in tight. Okay? I cast with my wrist and I practice cast. Biggest thing I can recommend is set up some targets in your backyard in the winter and practice, practice, practice. It's amazing. With just a little bit of practice, all of a sudden your casting will go right through the roof, and now you're going to catch a lot more fish just because you're able to cast that bait better, get it closer to the targets with less splash. So hey, there's some spinning rod basics on how to cast. Come back, I'm sure, next week, because I'm going to go into a little bit more in depth on how to do it with bait casting equipment. I know that's a lot more difficult. We're going to go into bait casting gear, and I'll see you next week. I'm Pete Gluzek.